I won't ask you guys if you were feeling draft, because I was. I know you were. I'd sign up for that draft again. Except for maybe the full screens of every terrible thing that's ever happened to a draftee's family. That was, you can't, come on. I understand why storytelling is important, but don't do that. Don't. Long story short, draft, thumbs up. Right, guys? Thumbs up? Absolutely. Let's start with the Patriots. Let's start with Belichick admitting today not drafting a QB. That wasn't the design, Mina Kimes. What does that mean to you?
It means that they went into this draft with a very specific idea of how they valued the quarterbacks. And I think after the first two, Joe Burrow and Tua Tagovailoa, they didn't think their options were better than Jarrett Stidham. This, to me, was a bet on Stidham. He is arguably the biggest winner of the draft. Now, I'm not entirely convinced that they're going to go into the season with him as a starter. Andy Dalton as a trade target is still out there. And, of course, Cam Newton, my preference for the team, and if they wanted to win in the near future, would be to go with those two. But I think this is an extreme vote of confidence in Jarrett Stidham, and it tells us how they view him relative to the other rookie quarterbacks.
Israel?
I'm kind of glad they didn't draft one, frankly, because I want to see one of these big names go to the Patriots, whether it be Newton or Dalton, and just see how that works. I also wonder if, you know, Tom and Rob or Rob Gronkowski are out there trying to have some fun. Maybe this is Bill Belichick's year to just have some fun, man. He had his dog on the screen in the draft. I mean, he wants to go with Stidham at his quarterback. Look, I have no idea who they're going to get in free agency, but the intrigue of what this Patriots team is going to be, possibly more intriguing than, I don't know, three or four of the last years with Tom Brady, because you almost knew what was coming. This is fascinating to me.
Do you think Belichick can have fun? Is that something he possesses in his tool bag? Do you think drafting a kicker with that tattoo is going to be fun for this team? Israel, do you have anything on that? Please, go ahead.
I mean, if you're going to draft a kicker, at least let it be one without any sort of issues, with any background or without any controversy.
How did that question not come up, honestly, both in the room, because we've had GMs ask about whether mothers are prostitutes in the past, all right? Think about that. But also, how did that come up in the interview room after when we're interviewing the Patriots, and that never came up with no media asked that, Mina Kimes? Defend your people.
We don't know that it didn't come up in the room between the staff and him. I'll just throw that out there first. Okay. Patriots do extensive research. And just to be clear, for those who don't know, we are talking about the Patriots kicker has a tattoo that references the three percenters, which the Southern Poverty Law Center defines as an anti-government group. When asked about it, the kicker, Justin Rohrwasser, said that it was a mistake. He didn't know what it was. He got it when he was young. He wants to get it covered. I think they're just natural follow-up questions now. Yeah. When did you realize what it was? Why have you had it for this long? And most importantly, why do you disagree with it now? We don't ask that enough. Explain what your objection to it is. And I think that's worth asking the Patriots as well.
Very well said, Mina. Tim Kalisha, join us here on the Patriots draft.
I think in terms of did it come up when the teams are talking to him, I'd wonder how many assistant coaches and scouts have any idea and even look at guys' tattoos or even know what that one means.
Okay, but they do ask questions about, again, mother's prostitute, whether the food that you cook is going to throw you off from your focus on the NFL.
That's a very specific thing because of the stories about Dez. I'm not saying it was a good question to ask, but I'm saying there's a reason that got asked, as crazy as that was. You know, in this case, I mean, every guy, 90% of the players have tattoos. I don't think they examine most of them. I think they're just talking to them about football. I want to get back to Belichick having fun. Israel's contention on that with the dog. I think the dog was something else. I think that was Belichick telling us, you guys get an empty chair or you get a dog. I'm not playing along with your game. And that's the same reason he answered the question, a quarterback it wasn't by design. It's his way of saying, we don't draft the way you people think we do. We don't go out there for need. We're above that. We take the best players. We'll be fine. You know, as far as the tanking and all, I agree with what Mina said about Stidham. I think it's Stidham's job to lose, and I think Stidham might be pretty good at it, actually.
You said tanking. You think Belichick would tank a season for Trevor Lawrence?
No. People are talking about, they're tanking because they got seven starters. They've lost since the end of the year. They didn't really have too much in free agency. People think they don't have a quarterback. He's not tanking for Trevor Lawrence.
All right. I wonder now if Kalisha was tanking this segment right here. Okay. Whether that needs to be muted or lost.
You tell me.
You know what? Just tell us you were being sarcastic and that's your out.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.